The offset function allows you to change the cell you refer to by moving the reference either up, down, left, or right as you require. This can be done automatically and is very useful for cash flow projections. In this segment, you'll learn how to activate and use this function. In this example, we have sales figures for a 5-month period, but what we know is that these sales don't get paid until either a month or two later. And what we'd like to build is when the cash is likely to be received, but to build in the option that we can change how long it takes to get the money. This can be achieved by using the offset function. To activate the offset function, you click on the cell, activate the function wizard, and find the offset function and click OK. The first question is what is its original reference point? And that will be just in the same time period. So you'll click up here. And then you can choose if you wanted to move along rows or do you want to move along columns. In this case, we wanted to look along columns. And what we wanted to do is to look at this column and, depending on the payment terms, get the column couple back. So if in month one there were sales of 100 and there's a 1-month payment period, we expect that month two we'll receive the money. So in this case, it would be a negative, and then we'll refer to this column and make it absolute. You can also tell the offset function to combine a number of rows if you put a number in the height, or a number of columns if you put a number in the width. However, for these purposes, we're going to just keep it to a simple offset. If you click OK and copy it across, what you'll see is at the moment it refers in the same month. But if we say that it takes 1 month to receive payment, if you just watch here, you'll see then it immediately automatically updates the fact that sales in this month will only be paid here, and we can put 2 here and that will automatically update. So month 2 sales of 200 are only going to be received in month 4.